Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I am going to show you how to schedule and track tasks in the Vue Gantt Chart component. You will learn how to set the task scheduling mode, working weeks, holidays, unscheduled tasks, critical paths, event markers, and indicators in a Gantt chart. First, I open my existing Vue project, where all the necessary Gantt chart modules are configured. I have added the data.js file, which has hierarchical local JSON data, and it is assigned to the datasource property. I also map the datasource fields to add the selective columns. If you would like to learn more about configuring a Vue Gantt chart, I recommend watching my Getting Started video. You can find the link to the video in the card above and the description below. Let me run this application using the command npm run serve. See here, the left pane has a tree grid, and the right pane has a chart with a project timeline. Now, I'll show you how to validate the start and end dates of a task scheduled in the Gantt chart. By default, the scheduling mode is set to auto, which validates the dates automatically based on various factors such as dependencies between tasks, holidays, weekends, and working time. The other modes are manual and custom. When the task scheduling mode is set to manual, the start and end dates are scheduled based on the data source without automatic validation for factors such as task dependencies, holidays, weekends, and working time. When the scheduling mode is set to custom, you can enable manual validation for certain tasks by mapping the Boolean property task fields.manual from the data source, while other tasks are validated automatically. Here, I'm going to show both automatic and manual validation using the custom scheduling mode. To use custom mode, I have added a field isManual, which indicates whether manual validation is required. And map the field isManual in the task field settings. Then, define the variable schedule mode and assign the custom mode. Assign this variable to the task mode property. The custom scheduling mode has been applied to the project timeline. Some tasks are scheduled automatically, while others are scheduled manually. In the manual task mode, the parent task will look like this, and the child task like this. You can also show unscheduled tasks in the project timeline. An unscheduled task is nothing but a task without any start date, end date, and zero duration. To display them, I add the allow unscheduled tasks property and set its value to true. Then I open the data.js file and change the duration to 0 for task 5 and remove the end date for task 6. Check now, task 5 is represented by a milestone. A milestone is a task that has no start and end dates, but has a duration value of 0. And task 6 has no end date. Now, I'll undo the changes in the data source to explain the other concepts clearly. By default, Saturday and Sunday will be highlighted as weekends in the bottom tier. To highlight the weekends in a project timeline, import the day markers module from the Vue Gantt package and inject it into the provide section. To view the working days in my project clearly, I highlight the weekends by enabling the Highlight Weekends property. If you want to include Saturday as a working day, use the WorkWeek property. To do that, I declare a variable, weekdays, and assign the values Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Then, assign this array variable to the workweek property. Check now, weekends are highlighted, and Saturdays have been included in the working day. Next, I will show you how to add holidays to the project timeline. I define the array variable leave details and specify the holiday from April 5, 2019 to April 6, 2019, and the label is Good Friday. Then, I define another holiday from April 11, 2019, and label it as a local holiday. And define May 1, 2019 as May Day. Finally, I assign leave details to the holidays property. See now, the specified holidays are shown in the project timeline. Now, I will show you how to highlight important events in a project. To do that, I declare the variable events and add the day property and assign the date April 2, 2019. Next, add another object with the date of April 9, 2019 and label it Design Phase. Assign the events to the event markers property of Gantt chart. Check now, the design phase event is marked in the project timeline. Next, I will show you how to render a Gantt chart with critical paths. A critical path is a series of tasks, or sometimes only a single task, that controls the calculated finish date of the project. If a task in a critical path is delayed, then the entire project will be delayed. To use a critical path, import this module from the Vue Gantt package and inject it into the provide object. Then add the enable critical path property and set its value to true. See the timeline, the critical path is shown. Finally, I will demonstrate how to show indicators in a project timeline. In the hierarchical object, I have added the field indicators in task 5, which has details like date, name, tooltip, and so on. In the task settings, map indicators as a data source field. See now, the indicator is shown in the project timeline. In this video, I have shown you how to schedule and track tasks in the Gantt chart component. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will get you a free license key to use our Vue products. If you found this video useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching.